Meanwhile, adaptation planning for the pelagic sargassum influxes and the impact of climate change on fisheries and aquaculture were among focus areas of the recently held 4th UWE Open Campus St. Lucia Country Conference. Details in this report.
The second phase of the JEF SGP UNDP Knowledge Fair and the UWI Open Campus St. Lucia Country Conference 2020-2021, which included the first National Honey Show Training Workshop, have been hailed a success. The UWI Open Campus St. Lucia, in collaboration with the JEF Small Grants Program, UNDP, hosted its fourth country conference under the theme Visioning Sustainable Futures, Confronting the Threats of Climate Change and Climate Variability, which provided a platform to share existing research and disseminate information on St. Lucia. Commenting on the close of the three-day conference, UWI Open Campus St. Lucia's Head of Site AG, Mistress Leslie Crane Mitchell, opined that while it was their fourth country conference, it was the first virtual conference.
It was our fourth country conference, but of course it was our very first virtual country conference, in keeping with the various protocols that we now all have to follow. The conference was a wonderful success. It took place over a three-day period. It began on the 15th, the evening on the 15th, with an opening ceremony.
The conference saw presentations focused on a range of climate change-related topics, including historical and future trends of climate-related hazards, St. Lucia's climate policy environment towards concrete action, the impact of climate change on fisheries and aquaculture, sustainable harvesting of the incense tree, adaptation planning for pelagic sargassum influxes in the Eastern Caribbean, a St. Lucia case study, and the Eastern Caribbean Solar Challenge.
All of them focus on climate change, but you basically had key areas represented. So the solar challenge, for example, that is facing the region, that was a big one that was focused on by the OECS, the huge problem that we've got with sargassum in all of the islands of our region, really, and of course in St. Lucia in particular, was paid a lot of attention to. We also had a number of presentations, also from the OECS and Ministry of Sustainable Development, which focused more on the various policies that need to be put in place if we are going to make any inroads on the climate change problem that we are currently experiencing. So we did have a wide cross-section and we had a very interesting one which looked at more the spiritual impact of climate change on all of us in the region. It was a very special presentation by our very own UWI PhD candidate, and it really lent a very special touch to the proceedings. Because there is a tendency to view climate change as strictly an economic, political, even and of course a scientific issue. But there is also, of course, the whole social and spiritual impact as well. So it really was all encompassing and a very, very rewarding few days.
Mrs. Green Mitchell concluded that the conference was altogether an enlightening 3 days, highlighting the urgent need for aggressive climate change adaptation in St. Lucia and the wider Caribbean, while providing local and regional beacons of hope within an often bleak global climate change context. In the same vein, the National Honey Show Training Workshop, held in February, is also being hailed a success by the organizers. The two-day event was undertaken to prepare beekeepers and various others in the sector to participate in the island's first-ever National Honey Show, scheduled to take place in December of this year. President of the Ianola Apiculture Collective, IAC, Richard Mathias, stated that this is the first activity of its kind directed at St. Lucia and regional beekeepers. While the event was facilitated by 4 world-class presenters, it was under the tutelage of leading expert and certified honey judge, Ms. Jennifer Holmes.
We had a number of very interesting facilitators over the two-day period. Day one, we had Jennifer Holmes, who is an international honey judge. She's based in Florida, and then she gave us a really good in-depth 3 hours or 3 to 4 hours on really how to prepare yourself for the various different categories. Carla Essen on day two, she gave a nice 1 hour presentation on rules and regulations and more on the mechanics of how we set up the Honey Show. But I think two Caribbean facilitators were really stole the show. Gladstone Solomon from Trinidad and Tobago and Dr. Velma Jessamy from Grenada. Gladstone has participated or has spearheaded Trinidad's participation in the London Honey Show for at least from I think 1987 to either 2000 or 2005, where Trinidad has won, participants from Trinidad have won a number of different categories or they've placed in a number of different categories. Dr. Velma Jessamy from Grenada, who is a multiple winner of the Hender Cup also. And you know, she has been a real trailblazer for the Caribbean and diversifying the honey product from the region into a more value-added area. So it was really good to have her on board as a presenter.
With a very positive response from participants locally and from around the region, Mafias feels compelled to make the island's first honey show a success and concluded that a second seminar will be hosted midway towards the competition date in order to ready participants for the honey show.
We still need to do some more groundwork locally to get our beekeepers really ready and prepared so that we can really have a really competitive environment. So there's a, you know, everybody's fully understands the rules and regulations. And we have probably have another seminar in June. This is a refresher and to really get everybody acquainted with the rules and regulations and, you know, to get a better idea of the numbers of people that will be participating in this year's competition. But at least by setting the stage early in the year in February, beekeepers have an opportunity to start setting aside their best honey or preparing for the various different categories from now. So at least they've got the whole season to really prepare and put aside what they think is going to be their best honey for competition.
Pleased with the success of the event organized by his organization, Jeff Small Grants Program UNDP, in conjunction with the Caribbean Youth Environmental Network St. Lucia Chapter, the National Coordinator Giles Romulus indicated that it is the intention of the Jeff SGP UNDP that these activities serve as a fillip for the development of the apiculture industry in St. Lucia and the OECS. He also noted that both components provided a valuable nexus with the broader Jeff SGP UNDP Knowledge Fair ideation component. With its solution-oriented approach to existing and looming environmental threats, which must be urgently addressed if St. Lucia is to have any chance of achieving a sustainable future. From the Government Information Service, Herma Dimark reporting.